Hey, Donald Trump, where's my $1,200? I see you doing a lot of yap, yap, yapping on TV and on the internet, but where's my fucking money, pal?
Stewie Beloved, we are gathered here today for another episode of the critically acclaimed hit show, Super Sexy Slutty Steaks.
Super Sexy Slutty, Sexy Slutty Steaks. Super Sexy Slutty, Sexy Slutty, Sexy Super Slutty Steaks.
The critically acclaimed hit show Super Sexy Slutty Steaks. Now this week we're at episode fucking 11. Now you know what that means. It means we're gonna get extra weird and extra frisky like this guy up on his patio. Now since you're watching episode 11, I thought we'd mix it up. You know, 11, a 1 and a 1. Together they make one thing. So for this special occasion, I thought we'd mix it up. And since we're kind of on a steer shortage with the whole quarantine apocalypse thing going on, I thought this week we'd cook up some meat discs, motherfuckers. Alright, so obviously, usually step three is name your steer. However, this week, since the steer is two meat discs, I feel like they should be named together as a tandem. I'm leaning towards Jose Canseco and Mark McGuire, the OG Bash Brothers. What do you little fucking slutty chefs out there think, huh? Guess it doesn't matter, this is already filmed. Jose Canseco, Mark McGuire it is then. Boom. All right, step one when you fire up a grill is making sure you use a very safe amount of this lighter fluid. Watch that shit fucking pour. Huh? You wanna remember, fire does not ask for consent.
Watch that shit fucking pour.
All right, once you got your shit all fluided up, you're gonna wanna hit it with the flame. Just like that. So all you super sexy slutty chefs are probably noticing, hey, I Rob Buffoon, why aren't you inside getting quarantined? Well, guess what? I'm on my patio. I know you've all been hanging outside. I thought I'd do things fun and do this one outside so you could all see it. Now, I'm assuming all of you also have a corner apartment unit with a wraparound balcony. I suggest you go hop on yours and cook your steer out there as well. If you don't, then pull yourself up by your bootstraps and go fucking get one because it's wonderful. I love my balcony. You should get a balcony. All right, I think this little fucker's hot enough to toss these little meat discs on now, huh? All right, everybody. Up next, batting third, Jose Canseco. Coming in to clean up, Mark McGuire. Missed a 70 home runs in 1998. You saved baseball, you're about to save my hunger.
In the field, number 70! How much more can you give us, Big Mac?
I hope you pieces of shit listened to me last week, and I hope you haven't been tugging on your hammer too much, because doctors aren't doing any non-essential work right now, and a hammer injury, as weird as it sounds, is actually not essential.
Oh, crap.
I guess I should have told you some fun facts about this little guy. But instead of fun facts, because burgers don't have much personality, I thought I'd run you through the burger chains and how I feel about them. Number one, obviously to me, I'm a California native who reps his fucking local area. So number one is obviously fucking In-N-Out. Number two, I'm gonna have to give it to Wendy of Wendy's. Three, I don't fucking know, Burger King, who gives a shit? I really just want to shout out to my boys, In-N-Out. You're the only Christians I fuck with. All right, so normally when it comes time to season up our sluts, we toss on the salt, the pepper, and the garlic. However, in this situation, I really only use salt and pepper with the burgers, and I'm talking just a dab. Let's take this pepper, throw it over there, take a little slap of salt, throw it over there, and let it just cook up and let yourself savor those super sexy, slutty juices of that steer disc yourself, eh? I'll see you when it's time to flip. Greasy, girthy, backyard burger. Greasy, girthy, backyard burger. Greasy, girthy, backyard burger. God, that's fun to say.
Greasy, girthy, backyard burger.
This little guy right here looks like he's cooking up nice. Why don't we hit it with that Swanton bomb, a little 450 splash, a little fucking moonsaw. Yep, you know what I'm talking about. Flip Gordon.
All right, now that both these motherfuckers have gotten the necessary flip, it's time to hit them with some of that classic American cheese. Now, much like most things from America, this cheese is not fucking real. So you vegans out there, talking to you, CC, you can probably actually fucking eat it. It goes pretty easy. You slap it on one, you take it, you slap it on the other. Whew, that fire's fucking hot, but I can handle it because I'm a professional.
All right, it's not that cheese is all melted up like a dirty little slut in a jacuzzi. You're gonna wanna pop one burr on top of the other burr. Look at that drip, drip, drip. Ooh, swag, what they call it. Here's an album for all you super sexy, slutty chefs out there. You want a history lesson? Here it is. Cheeseburgers were invented in the Jewish communities of Europe in the 1800s by a family known as the Weinbergs. I believe Max Weinberg, the drummer for the E Street Band, descended upon them. Anyways, these were originally called Weinbergers, and you'd pair them with a nice port wine or a sherry. Over time, it became more of a fast food thing when Ronald and Wendy and them got in the game, but let's not forget, this was created by our Jewish comrades. Looking out to you, Nick. Shabbat shalom, brother. All right, so once those little steer discs are off the cooker, it's about time to prep up that bun. Now, like I said, I cooked mine a little, not too much, because if you make it black, it'll never go back. Now, on the bottom part, you're gonna wanna put a dab of ketchup, mustard, and mayonnaise. Now, I had to do it off camera because it was deemed too sexual the way I was splurting the ketchup onto the bun. Now, I don't want to say anything out there, but fuck you, Mark Zuckerberg, and all you Puritan censors out there. So anyways, while I'm waiting around this knife, we're going to want to spread this nice, mix it up nice and evenly, get you a nice little red, yellow, white. It's like a Hulk Hogan bottom. A Hulk Hogan bottom.
We've been hanging and banging, brother.
Once you have your Hulk Hogan bottom,
brother, 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 brothers.
And what you do is you take your two little lumps of steer, you place it on top there. That's not it though. You remember that thing your uncle always asked to tickle when you were a kid? Your pickle? You want to place three of these neatly upon the top. Now you'll see right here, the pickles kind of make a face. Yes, you want a pickle face. Then you're going to take this part right here, leave it plain as day if you like, plop it on top. Now look at that super sexy, slutty hunk of steer disc wrapped in fucking bun! God, I'm having too much fun. I'm getting frisky myself. There's a lot of neighbors outside right now.
Hello, everybody. Thanks a lot for coming out to the cheeseburger picnic.
I'm not gonna lie to you, it's been a while since I fired up one of these little fuckers myself, so I guess it's time I bite in and tell you how it is, eh? Oh my fuck. After this bad boy, I think I earned myself a new nickname. Cheeseburger Daddy. And that's just a metaphor. I never made sex to any of your mothers out there. Oh my fuck. I don't think. Oh my fuck. 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 Oh my fuck.
How many did you drive into that big fucking cheeseburger locker?
All right, now that that tasty little motherfucker that I named the Bash Brothers, aka Jose Canseco and Mark McGuire, is all up in my gut, I guess it's time for me to rate that steer. Now, we had a special episode here. The first time we've ever not cooked traditional steak, we did steer discs. And in honor of that, I gotta rate it pretty generously. Not just to be nice, like a youth soccer team, but because it genuinely fucking deserves it. These burgers are incredible, and I don't wanna lie to you, I might make the best burgers in the fucking world. That being said, I'm gonna give it a 5 out of 7 perfect fucking score. God, that was fucking good. How was yours at home? I'm assuming you cooked along with me, right? I hope you're careful around that fire. Don't forget, fire is much like Harvey Weinstein. It does not believe in consent. It will get you at any time.
What's that shit fucking boy?
I guess that about does it for us this week on Super Sexy Slutty Steaks. I hope you had fun. I hope you tune in again on the next episode, and I hope you're having the quarantine of your life, cooking up your own frisky meals and thinking up quarantivities to keep your quarant busy during this quarant fucking nightmare, huh? Do me a favor in the meantime, though. You know, stay super, stay sexy, stay slutty, stay safe.
I'm fighting for life, brother.
I want all you super sexy slutty chefs out there to do me a favor. Make sure you click on our video right down there, hit the like, hit the subscribe, leave a comment, and most importantly, show us that you believe in life after love, and share us with all your pretty pals. Do you believe in life after love? Hell, my fuck, motherfuckers. I feel something inside me say, I really don't think you're strong enough now. Do you believe?
About your booty that you're going to go to dubbic.com, baby.
Bye, guys.